Hello and welcome back to the Gaming Guild. Alex here with day 43 of 7 Days to Die. We don't have Kylie anymore. She spent 2 weeks with us and now I'm back on my own. Couple changes. Oh, we lost our picnic table. A couple changes since I last played. You'll probably see it down in the bottom right corner, but I went ahead and changed some of the settings. So I made the night as long as possible. It's now 12 hours of daytime, 12 hours of nighttime. That's nice. I also increased the running speed of zombies, at night, feral zombies and blood moon zombies. To jog, or sorry, from jog to run. I don't have them up to sprint yet. Kind of like when I started, playing by myself, it's really easy for zombies to overwhelm me. So, do just have that turned down a little bit to help me out while I'm solo. But yeah, this is kind of going to be the new normal for me, at least for a while. Just longer night times, a little bit faster zombies, and we'll see how that goes. It took down a light pole in the last blood moon. That was interesting. Then the light pole turned into wood for some reason. I was a little curious to see if I extended night, if the blood moon would start back up, but it doesn't look like it. So it'll be interesting to see what time blood moons are. Now that I've done that. And I also am not quite sure what time the trader will open, what time morning officially is. I didn't get the music there, so it doesn't seem like 7 a.m. is dawn. One bullet's fine. But I have repair kits on me, so my SMG. Let's head over to the trader and see what's going on with him. The storm isn't really helping things either. Looks like dawn's on its way. Other than, just generally making the game harder, I don't have too much planned. Definitely try to do, more missions. Just try to keep things exciting. At least at the moment, it's nothing new. At some point, I'll probably move to a new city and build a new base there. Haven't quite figured that out when I want to do that yet. Possibly once I have better vehicles that I can make. Oh, this is open. It's nighttime. Well, somebody had suggested that I check out the secret room. Oh, interesting. We've looked in and saw this, but we've never been down here. Pretty interesting. I'll let him keep his rotten meat. Ooh, cat food. Most important meal of the day, serving it up Bastion's way. Blech. So nothing game-changing in here. Would have been a good way to get some early magazines. Good to know for future. Would have been really funny if there's a toilet pistol in there. Well, oh, I have that open now. Right. Well, let's see if Joel has any missions for us. It's kind of hard to tell where when morning actually is with the storm going still.
Come speak with me.
Any jobs?
Can you do me a favor?
Rested clear at
Well,
the
it's always
hospital.
tomorrow. I like you, friend.
That
Pleasure was all
is
mine.
all far away.
You take care. Would you
Infested
kindly
clear
help
at
me with
Hearts
a
from Rent-A-Car.
maybe next time? I have a
Or
dilemma.
Hotel
Could you use some assistance?
Zambona. Let's go ahead and take
Godspeed.
that one. A little fun at that hotel. You know what? I have some repair kits. Most of the junk that I have on me is stuff that I'd be picking up anyways. Let's just head on over. The hotel, so hopefully there's some food and water and someplace. And I can always drink murky water now, so that's kind of a good backup. Sorry if my voice is a little less energetic than normal. Just been having a couple busy weeks with work, getting caught up on a lot of recording since we're just about to take off on our vacation. Had my first runner. Kylie and I are taking a little bit of a vacation, so we're just trying to get caught up on some videos. So by the time you see this, we will be back from our vacation. Oh, it says it's still night, but I feel like it has to be morning. I have it set for, 12 hours of daytime, 12 hours of nighttime. Now, if it's morning at 10 a.m., then it's night at 10 p.m. It's like the night doesn't change, just how long it goes until morning. Weird. Right. Interesting. I have to have one explosive arrow on my bow. I'll save that. Good morning. All right. I've never been to this hotel before, so I have no idea of where exactly I'm supposed to be going. A lot of mixed signals just because there is a lot of light in here. Like, just doesn't really give a clear, hey, go in this direction. That's just outside. I think I pulled some outside zombies. Ooh, kite pistol. if you've been enjoying this series so far, I do have one pretty big question that I would love as much feedback as possible on, and that is, do people want me to stay 366 days in this world using the save? Or do you think I should do a restart at some point? Harder difficulty at the beginning of a new playthrough? So you can see, you know, tough for zombies, but back in the beginning when I only had a primitive bow and things like that. So please comment, let me know. It'd be a big help for just having some good direction for this this playthrough for me. Okay. Well, at this point, it really seems like the game wants me to go upstairs here. Okay. There's not much light to it. Maybe I'll pop a hole in it and I can shoot him through it. There we go. Second floor. I was looking to see if there's a way back to the other side. Oh, here we go. Or not. The other side have something better? No. Let's see. There we go. Paper. Nothing interesting. Nothing interesting. Paper. Oh, a lot of nothing. I think this is close enough to durability loss that we might as well repair it. Okay, just on the north end of town there. Second elevator? Interesting. I wonder if that elevator shaft is going to lead all the way down from the top to the bottom into that back room that I wasn't able to access before. Here is a little bit better. Give me some light signals. Oh, really? I know this is a tier 4 area, but for an infested clear, this is a little on the light side. Ooh. I don't think I was supposed to come in here quite yet. I'll skip it. Another thing, if you guys do show an interest in me just restarting in a new world at some point, it does make it so I could try to get some people in for a multiplayer game that we can just add to the series and see everybody starting out. Oh, yeah, they're getting faster. One bullet. I don't think I searched this room. basement level. Apparently adds some length to the level, but really hasn't added anything to the difficulty yet. Well, come back to that later. Now we'll just go up. Third floor is locked. See any birds? That's good. I can drop down a floor there. Switched my shotgun for a little bit. Hey, there's a place to drop down too. There's a couple different options. This is where the light is right now. I kind of feel like this is probably the best choice. Let's take a little snack break. Top off our food and water. Let's check this side out really quick before I move on. I knew this was that apartment I could have, or hotel room I could have dropped down to. So I just want to check this really quick before moving on. Nothing special here. There's the stairwell. Couple zombies. Come on, you guys. Oh, Check this one first. And this one has the bathroom with ladder going down. Too bad. Ooh, interesting. Oh, really? There's only one more area? Okay. I hope it's like a million zombies, because this place has not been that exciting. Either that or the game just bugged and didn't spawn in a lot of zombies that it should have. That's all of them. Check that in a minute. Well, eat some food. Things that I can drop. Need these painkillers. Good stuff. So let's see, figuring out things I'm going to leave behind. Some lead. Aloe cream. Fort bites. I think I have a few polymer strings already. I don't think I have an active map, so let's see if I can read that really quick. To whomever finds this note, friend, the end is near. The monsters are breaking down my door, but in my final moments, I can only think of how I want to be remembered. Not as a coward, but as someone who thinks of others. I leave this map to one of my many secret buried chests to you. God bless you, Jennifer. I would have liked it better if it was just like a funny message, like, no, I don't want people to remember me as a coward, but here I am in a closet shitting my brains out because I'm so scared, and just add a little bit of humor to it. Nothing wrong with that. I think we mentioned before that the story is pretty unclear in this game. You just wake up naked and you get a message about, you know, crossing the Duke, but then you never really meet the Duke or anything. So, like, they could have done a little bit more to, invest in the story. I'll just scrap that. Okay. Let's see where this goes. Cooking pot if I needed it. Ooh. Flock of birds. Birds. I thought there was one more. All right. Let's see. I guess I head back to the trader, but I don't really have anything that I want to sell. Let's make a quick trip back to the house. Yeah, 12 hours of daytime, or 12 hours of nighttime, was as low as I could go. It wouldn't let me do any more nighttime than that. Which is funny, because I guess this this location should still be able to get darker than that. Not like we're right on the equator where 12 and 12 is the limit of what we can do. But yeah, since it seemed like 10 o'clock in the morning was morning, pretty sure that 10 o'clock at night will still be nighttime, so that's not gonna change on me at all. And yeah, it'll just be interesting to see when the blood moon ends on the end of the week. You know, will it still stop at 4 a.m. and just go to normal nighttime after that, or will the blood moon just keep going? Alright, let's head back over to the trader. There's a delicious chicken right there, but you wanted to go for me instead. It definitely is a lot lonelier without Kylie with us.
Gratitude, friend.
Let's see. Level 5 sniper rifle. It's pretty nice. A level 5 nail gun. Funny, I just made one for the Blood Moon. Well, I think I'm gonna take a second nail gun. Just cause then I can, you know.
I really admire you, friend. God bless you.
Give it to somebody else if you do multiplayer. You know, and we have a couple of us at the base protecting it. Or focusing on repairing during the Blood Moon. Just kind of make it an interesting experience. Hearts rent a car. Go ahead and do that. I have the trainer there. I have a mission for. I have a supply drop. I have a treasure map. So let's make this active. Does it show? There's a treasure. And there's the trade route. Okay. Let's see. I could go drop off the nail gun and drink a little bit of water. You know what? I'm not going to worry about it. Go pick up that airdrop. I'll probably have some water or tea or something in it. I usually do. And worst case scenario, I can just drink some murky water next time I come across some. Yeah, if I ever have to travel longer, like leave this town, I'll definitely grab my motorcycle for that. But as long as I'm in town, kind of just stick to the bicycle. Lemon residence. Where are we on the map? Up here. Yeah. Some Savage Country stores. I need a little Savage Country and then a bigger Savage Country. Judith Witch. I've never actually been inside there. Or Judy Witch, not Judith. Let's see. Oh hey, it's another one of my houses. Crafting skill magazines. Ammo crafting bundle. Droids, first aid bandage. I'll take all of it. Army again. Buggy. Can't really tell if that was supposed to be a horde that was pretty calm, or just because I haven't really been on this part of town too much, that it just had some zombies still chilling from initial spawn. Sub guy. Are you a top? Or are you a sub? Been to a Subway sandwich in California that's like this. Rude. I didn't do anything to you. So no head. Hey, there's a Ford. Took him long enough. Or not? Just some more randos? Okay. I will say that it would be a little scarier at the beginning if no ferals and night zombies ran as fast as this for me. Just thinking of like, oh, primitive bow and, you know, using a stone spear. No. Wouldn't have really been able to handle nighttime zombies that well. And part of that too is, you know, I want to make this entertaining for you guys. It probably wouldn't have been that entertaining if the first week of the game, you know, every night I just spend it hunkered down inside whatever shelter I'm in, not coming out, not doing anything to alert zombies, because, you know, I'm just too afraid to deal with them in the early game. By having them, you know, run slower and not be the highest difficulty, made it so that early on I could be, you know, out and about at night, taking on missions and not really worrying too much about higher difficulty just because it's nighttime. And then it makes it fun now, so being able to switch it back and having that little bit more challenge, zombies get up to me a little bit faster. All right. Sixty-nine vehicle books. Pretty good. Any points available? I do have some. Picking another shotgun pro. Pick another minor 69er. Two minor 69ers. Really make it so I can harvest better. Alright. Zombies, where you at? Ooh, some actual made coffee. Nice. Drink some of that right now. Eat some chili. Tuna, eat that. Hey, I've seen her before. Birds. It's always interesting to break the game by like, geez. Going around an area. Because you get to see them spawn in and then... yeah, it is just kind of funny seeing the different reactions from it. Well, before I go any further, I should get back to normal schedule. Yeah, I would have gone down the windowsill, come into here, seen all this. That's locked. I'll have some chicken stock, save the red tea. Stairwell. Just grab these books really quick. Ooh, I unlocked making the 4x4. That's cool. Of course, now I won't have anybody with me for a bit, so not really going to be able to put it to any good use. See. Heaven. There you guys are. Just deal with all of you at once. Let's see. Locked. Food. Interesting. Alright. Down we go. Ooh, quality 5 military armor. Okay. Don't want to miss any books. Don't want to miss any zombies. Ah, finally got this one. Urban Combat 3. Sneaking over trash makes no sound. And that finishes those. What's the grand bonus for that? Which one is it? Urban combat. Silencers have no damage penalty. That's really nice and makes me really wish I had a silencer. Alas, this game just does not want to give me one. Let's see. That's locked. So this is the next place to go. Coffee? No coffee. That's another thing with your comments today. If you do like the idea of me starting new games so that you can see the beginning and everything, one thing I'd probably do is play one of the other map types. This one's huge, but it doesn't have a lot of terrain difference. It's all kind of the same foresty area. I haven't really gotten to the edges, but from what I've seen so far, there's not a lot of variance. So I'll probably play one of the ones that have... I think the smallest one has just... All the biomes are all kind of mashed together. Or at least like right next to each other, and then, like, the whole exterior has like radiation that you have to deal with. So I know that was an older map, so I'm not sure if there's still like radiation or anything like that. Try to sneak up on me. Feel like it took damage after they both died. Maybe I'm mistaken. Good attempt. Oh, it was this big guy. Saw him earlier. Well, from here. I'll go up onto this. I guess these guys would have popped out by now. here. Come up here. Anybody else active? Come up here. This is open now. And now I'm a little confused. Oh, down here. Duh. Okay. Never mind. I'm back. Is this where the actual, like, car lot is? Yeah. I need that. Here. Alright, give me something to hit. Right, that's all of them. I don't really need a tire. I'll take a lockpick, sure. And that guy. Okay. Food. Steroids I don't need. Don't need that. I really don't need the chrysanthemums. I was just picking them up in case. Drop this, get the ammo. Really don't need the extra food or the first aid kit. Nothing good there. Next that out. That's cool. Come on. There we go. Read that, read that. Grab as much as I can. Let's grab the serrated blade. Scrap, 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 scrap. No room. Scrap it. Okay. Just to get as much iron as I can. Well, let's start heading back. I am going to still try to end it at 6 a.m. We'll see when it gets to the Blood Moon if I keep that at the end of the week. But for now, even though it's nighttime, I want to try to keep the same length of videos. So thank you everyone for joining me. Hope you had fun. Hope you like longer nighttime and the faster zombies. But I will see you all in the next adventure. Bye-bye.